In order to understand both the spirit of tradition and its antithesis, modern civilization, it is necessary to begin with the fundamental doctrine of the two natures. According to this doctrine, there is a physical order of things and a metaphysical one. There is a mortal nature and an immortal one. There is a superior realm of being and an inferior realm of becoming. Generally speaking, there is a visible and tangible dimension, and prior to and beyond it, an invisible and intangible dimension, that is the support, the source, and the true life of the former. Traditional man knew the existence of the physical world and the totality of the forms, whether visible or underground, of hyperchromia, a world beyond this world. According to tradition, the former is the fall of the latter, and the latter represents the liberation of the former. Spirituality was believed to be something beyond life and death. Mere physical existence, or living, was meaningless unless it approximated the higher world, or that which is more than life, and unless its highest ambition consisted in participating in hyperchromia and in obtaining a final liberation from the bond represented by the human condition. According to tradition, every authority is fraudulent, every law is unjust and barbarous, every institution is vain and ephemeral, unless they are ordained to the superior principle of being, and unless they are derived from above and oriented upwards. The traditional world knew divine kingship. It knew the bridge between the two worlds, namely initiation. It knew the two great ways of approach to the transcendent, namely heroic action and contemplation. It knew the mediation, namely rites and faithfulness. It knew the social foundations, namely traditional law and the caste system. And it knew the political earthly symbol, namely the empire. These are the foundations of the traditional hierarchy in civilization that have been completely wiped out by the victorious anthropocentric civilization of our contemporaries.